he says that he refers to the verse of the Holy Quran. لو كنت عالم الغيبة لاستكثرت من الخير وما مسني السوء. If I had known the unseen secret, I would have collected a lot of wealth and no evil would have touched me. This is the translation of this verse. But we shall ask what you are trying to prove. The negation of the unseen secret by Muhammad Mustafa, this cannot be proved. Because this is hypothetical sentence. Qaziyya, shartiyya, muttasila, luzumiyya.
Subhanallah.
Hypothetical sentence. The proper way to achieve the logical deduction, you will have to negate the subsequent. Since I have got no wealth and I could not be saved from the evil, therefore I don't know the unseen secret. This sentence cannot be said, because Nabi Kareem Sallallahu Alaihi Wasallam had a great wealth. For instance, when Nabi Kareem Sallallahu Alaihi Wasallam conquered Khaybar, Nabi Kareem Sallallahu Alaihi Wasallam got two gardens, well irrigated. Every inch of that area was irrigated, and so many vegetables and other crops were cultivated there. And at least there were two vast garden of the palm trees, producing thousands of rupees or dirham or dinar yearly. And then when he come to Fadak, he got that area as well. And when Nabi Kareem Sallallahu Alaihi Wasallam migrated from Mecca Sharif to Medina Tayyiba, acres and acres of cultivated land was consecrated, Nazrani ke taur par dena, was consecrated to Muhammad Mustafa Sallallahu Alaihi Wasallam by the companions of the Holy Prophet.
Subhanallah.
And then he conquered an area which is called Ghaba. Many murabbas of the land was possessed by Muhammad Mustafa Sallallahu Alaihi Wasallam, because that was also Mali Fair. And there was a person who was Jew. And he said that, if I die, if I martyred in Uhud Sharif, my seven garden of the vegetables and seven gardens of the palm trees would be possessed by Nabi Kareem Sallallahu Alaihi Wasallam, because I am issueless. And since he was martyred in Uhud Sharif, therefore, Mukhairik, his name, the Jew, name of Jews was Mukhairik. The seven irrigated garden were possessed by Muhammad Mustafa Sallallahu Alaihi Wasallam on behalf of Mukhairik. He embraced Islam on the same day, and he was martyred on the same day. Therefore, seven garden of that person was also possessed by Nabi Kareem Sallallahu Alaihi Wasallam. Now, let me know whether he collected a lot of wealth or not. And when Banu Qurayza and Banu Nazir, they were exiled from Medina Tayyiba, since their land was also possessed by Muhammad Mustafa Sallallahu Alaihi Wasallam, and they are defined as Mal-e-Fay. Mal-e-Fay is directly possessed and is the property of the ruler of the country. Therefore, the area which is beyond the mountain, which is nearby the railway station of Medina Tayyiba, that total area was possessed and owned by Muhammad Mustafa Sallallahu Alaihi Wasallam. Now let me know whether Nabi Kareem Sallallahu Alaihi Wasallam collected the wealth or not. And Nabi Kareem Sallallahu Alaihi Wasallam said, "Lo sheto la sarat maiya jibalu zab." Collected or not? Othitul kanzayne Bukhari, Othitul kanzayne al Akhmar wal Abyad. The reservoirs of the treasuries of the silver and gold were given to me. Collected or not? Wallahu yuti wa inna ma ana qasimun. Whatever is granted by Allah for the creature, I am to distribute. Collected or not?
Subhanallah. Subhanallah.
So this is the proof. That's no good. And ma masaniya su. Sue is mostly used in the Quranic text for shirk. Means, if I had known the unseen secret, the shirk, the infidelity or paganism, idolatry. The two words are used for shirk. Idolatry or paganism. Paganism would not have touched me. Did paganism touch Muhammad Sallallahu Alaihi Wasallam? Never. Both of the conditions were found. So, what is the way to achieve the result? You will have to say, Walakin.
Huh?
This is Qasi Istisnai. Hypothetical syllogism. This is called in English, hypothetical syllogism. You will have to attach, but I have collected the wealth, and I have been saved from the evil. So it means that I know the unseen secret.
Subhanallah.
But if you negate that, Nabi Kareem Sallallahu Alaihi Wasallam could not be given the great wealth. Quran says, Anzalallahu alaykal kitab.
Subhanallah.
Wal hikmah. Wa'allamaka ma'lam tukatalam. Allah has revealed the book towards you and the wisdom as well. Wa man yutal hikmata faqad utiya khairan kaseera. Lastakthartu min al-khair. If I had known the unseen secret, I would have collected the great wealth. Quran says, Anzalallahu alaykal kitab wal hikmah. This is a minor premise. Allah has revealed to you the book, the hikmat. This is sughra, minor premise. Minor premise means sughra. And kubra, man yutal hikmata faqad utiya khairan kaseera. This is kubra, major premise. Major premise is, man yutal hikmata faqad utiya khairan kaseera. Whosoever was given the hikmah, he was given khair-e kaseer. Nabi Kareem Sallallahu Alaihi Wasallam said, if I had known the unseen secret, I would have collected khair-e kaseer. Quran says khair-e kaseer was given to you.
Subhanallah.
Understand? And the next question is, Nabi Kareem Sallallahu Alaihi Wasallam doesn't know what is going to happen with himself or with his followers. So the verse of the Holy Quran can be referred in this connection. La adri ma yuf'alu bi wa la bikum. I am the prophet of Allah, but I don't know what is going to happen to you or to myself. How you are going to dealt with or myself. So this is the verse of the Holy Quran, but unfortunately, this is abrogated one. This was abrogated. And Nabi Kareem Sallallahu Alaihi Wasallam said, Allama Abdurrahman Damishki, Rasala Nasukum and Zuh. This was abrogated by the verse of the Holy Quran. Fatahna laka fatahan mubeen alli yaghfira laka Allahu ma taqaddama min
Subhanallah.
My Holy Prophet, whosoever attaches himself, affiliates himself to you, he would be pardoned. I will never consider the volume of the sins, the caste, the area, the country, the name, the caste, the bank balance. Just we shall see his affiliation with you. If he is affiliated with you, howsoever sinful he is, but he would be pardoned. This verse is abrogating that verse. And in addition to that, وَلَا سَوْفَ يُعْتِيكَ رَبُّكَ فَتَرْضَى. How one can say that Nabi Kareem Sallallahu Alaihi Wasallam is not aware about his own end or the end of his followers when Allah says, O my Holy Prophet, I swear. This lam is kasmiya. But this lam can be objected as a kasmiya, because there is a rule when lam qasam comes in front of the present indefinite tense, noon taqid sakila should be attached in the last. But here, Nun Taqid Sakila was not attached. Therefore, this Qasam, this Lam is not for Qasam. But this is totally wrong. Because the opinion of Hazrat Hadr Karrar, he says that when there is anything intervening between the Lam-e Qasam and the present indefinite tense, then this liability is not imposed. That law can be exempted. Just like, La ilallahi turja'ul amur. This Lam is bil-ittifaq. Admittedly, Lam-e-Qasam. But La ilallahi